ADOS is everywhere. Cut the check.
Going on families, bill money, Dirty Laundry Media. Back with a story that you might find interesting. I know I did. And what we're talking about today is a phenomenon in which sworn judges are actually helping illegal immigrants escape detainment by ICE. And this story is a most recent one. This occurred in Massachusetts. This is a story that I found on CNN, among other websites. But I know black people trust CNN, so I decided to use this link just to bring you up to speed. If you're here, go ahead and hit that like button. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe to Dirty Laundry Media. Thank you for watching. So what we have here, headline reads, judge accused of helping an undocumented immigrant escape an ICE officer. So what we have is a Massachusetts judge and a former court officer are accused of helping a twice deported undocumented defendant elude immigration authorities by slipping out a rear courthouse door. Newton District Court Judge Shelley Richmond Joseph, 51, and former trial court officer Wesley McGregor, 56, were indicted Thursday on obstruction of justice and other federal charges. They face counts of conspiracy to obstruct justice, obstruction of justice, obstruction of a federal proceeding, aiding and abetting, according to an indictment in U.S. District Court in Boston. McGregor was also charged with one count of perjury. This case is about the rule of law, U.S. Attorney Andrew Lilling said in a statement. We cannot pick and choose the federal laws we follow or use our personal views to justify violating the law. Let's see if we can get this going. But apparently what we have here is a judge basically with a bleeding heart for illegal immigrants deciding to allow a twice deported illegal immigrant waltz out of the courthouse through a rear door. And these are the things that, you know, are going undiscussed and not really talked about, you know, but this immigration issue. You know, not only do we have our politicians going super hard in the paint to make illegals legal after breaking the law. Now we have judges who are sworn to uphold the law.
Federally charged. This is an amazing story. According to prosecutors, now the judge is District Court Judge Shelley Richmond Joseph, and she has been federally charged herself with obstruction of justice, conspiracy to commit obstruction of justice, and perjury, to name a few of the charges. And the story goes back to the beginning, which is important. There was a man by the name of Jose Medina Perez, and he had entered the country two times illegally, 2003 and 2007, deported both times. After that, an order by an immigration judge in the United States said that he could not enter the country again for 20 years. He did enter the country again a third time. He was arrested in Massachusetts last March for a narcotics charge and also as a fugitive out of Pennsylvania. Once arrested, his fingerprints were put in the system, and that allowed ICE to realize just through the electronic system that this is the person we have an order for that is not to come back into this country. So 1 month later was his arraignment on the narcotics charge and the federal warrant as a fugitive out of Pennsylvania. The ICE agent walked into the public courthouse, told everyone that he was there, from the clerk to the defense attorney. He sat in the public area. And that is when then the arraignment proceeding began. And I want you to listen to prosecutors today out of Massachusetts as they describe what happened next between the judge and the defense attorney.
Told Judge Joseph that if AS was released, ICE would pick him up. Judge Joseph replied, quote, ICE is going to get him, unquote. And seconds later ordered the recording equipment turned off. The judge and defense attorney then conspired to have AS released out the back door of the courthouse to avoid the ICE officer. When the recorder was turned back on, defense counsel asked for permission to accompany AS downstairs to lock up on a pretext, to which Judge Joseph agreed.
So what happened next? The audio is turned back on. The defense attorney said, Your Honor, I do need to take him downstairs to continue to talk with him through an interpreter. Prosecutors say that was a ruse to get him to the back door. They opened up the back door. He left. The ICE officer remained there for a long time, believing with that warrant in hand, immigration warrant, that he was going to be exiting the courtroom. He did not. Now, the ACLU has responded to all of this today in the judge's behalf, saying the Department of Justice's decision to bring this case is preposterous, ironic, and deeply damaging to the rule of law.
So, yeah, this is what we're dealing with. In 2019, you know, the fact that he had been twice deported, that he was currently being charged with some sort of drug charge, and he was allowed to escape while an ICE officer waited in the courthouse. So again, this was in Massachusetts. This was a recent case, but there was a case in Oregon in 2017. Judge Monica Herranz, she also allowed a illegal immigrant to elude capture. And this says in January 27th of 2017. Monica Herranz, they saying that she, and this was an article, a follow-up article in which she was back actually cleared of any wrrongdoing, and they say she didn't knowingly help impaired driving defendant Didier Pacheco Salazar elude capture, excuse me. So yeah, in her defense, she said that Herranz didn't know if the defendant was indeed in the country illegally. Rather, all she'd been told by Pacheco Salazar's defense attorney was that the defendant didn't have his immigration documentation with him, and with and U.S. agents with U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement were in the hall asking various defendants of Hispanic ethnicity for their documentation. Herranz asked if the prosecutor had any objection, and upon hearing none, agreed to let Pacheco Salazar leave through the back door of her courtroom, which is accessible to other members of the public. So again, this was in Oregon. We have another case here in Philadelphia. This is another recent case. Philadelphia released undocumented man charged with assault despite receiving federal arrest warrant. U.S. Attorney William M. McSwain says he has a question for Philadelphia Mayor Jim Kenney. Where is Alan Torres Gomez, an undocumented Mexican man twice charged with assault? So this is a violent criminal. Illegal immigrant from Mexico. Says McSwain's ire stems from an incident that holds the Kenny administration's sanctuary city policies up for criticism. Gomez's release from local custody, despite the fact that federal immigration authorities provided the city with a signed judicial arrest warrant to ensure he would be held. Those federal warrants are the Kenny administration's standard for keeping people in custody beyond the time they would normally be released from jails and lockups. The city does not honor detainers from U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement, deeming them insufficient, but says it always cooperates with warrants signed by a judge. So they're letting it be known that they're not complying with any detainers from ICE, saying they're insufficient, but they alleging that they're going to cooperate with warrants signed by a judge. In this case, McSwain says that's not true, that in this 2018 case, city officials ignored a warrant for a man who had been most recently charged with assault and recklessly endangering another person, and who had twice been deported from the United States. Managing Director Brian Abernathy said Gomez was released by mistake. There was a clerical error, Abernathy said. Somebody screwed up. That person was held accountable. I cannot blame ICE for this error. It was not their fault. Frankly, I was furious when it was brought to my attention. So again, this is what we're dealing with, people. Not only is there a crisis in the border, there seems to be a crisis in the courts. We have judges who are actually helping, aiding, abetting, facilitating what amounts to an escape from federal detainment by ICE. We have states like Florida. Florida Senate passes a sanctuary cities ban. After months embroiled in emotional testimony, protests, controversy, and national news coverage, Senator Joe Gruder's version of a bill to ban sanctuary cities in Florida passed 22-18 in the Senate Friday. Senator Anatir Flores of Miami was the only Republican to vote against the bill. The vote came after 2 days of impassioned floor debate by Democrats and Republicans alike, telling personal stories of their own family's immigration or the stories of their constituents. So yeah, this is from the Tampa Bay Times. You guys can go look that story up. So yeah, we have a Philadelphia judge. We have an Oregon judge. We have a Massachusetts judge. Helping illegal aliens escape. So yeah, people, I'm not gonna hold you all too much longer. Just wanted to drop this again on this very important topic of immigration, illegal immigration. I'll be back with some updates. Got some more stories cooking. Again, go ahead and hit that like button. If you haven't already subscribed, please do subscribe, share my videos. Drop down in the comment section. Let me know what you think. Again, this is Bill Money with Dirty Laundry Media, signing off.